Today, I will show you the features of ClickSync and what are the pros and cons of ClickSync. Okay? Because ClickSync is also a tool which is being derived from the mother company Click, and the earlier product was ClickView. Now we will see what are the best features of the ClickSync is being created added into the ClickSync package, and what all the topics has been inherited from ClickView. So let's see. ClickSync is a self-service data visualization tool. Now when I say self-service, and it's also a business intelligence tool, you can say. Now when I say ClickSync is a business intelligence tool, what is business intelligence? Business intelligence is a domain basically. It is not a tool specifically, we can say. It's a domain. Business is something, a practice of money making, and intelligence is a knowledge. So, knowledge required to create effective business intelligence or execute effective business intelligence is generated from the advanced tools like ClickSync, ClickView, Power BI, Tableau and all. So out of all those contemporary tools, ClickSync is one of the most demanding or widely used BI tool in the current market. So ClickSync deliver business intelligence or business discovery platform that supports a BI analytics. So it has taken, as I say, the pros of ClickView, and there are few cons of ClickView which has been omitted in ClickSync, which has been reduced in ClickSync, as compared to comparing to the competitors like Tableau and other BI tools. So like in ClickView, we did not have the map objects, geographical analysis, storytelling, mobile, in responsive mobile development platform. So that all has been improvised in ClickSync. In ClickSync, you have an inbuilt graphical interface for GIS analysis, for various layer analysis in ClickSync. It has lot of additional extensions which can be easily embedded with ClickSync or integrated with ClickSync to use the additional features like D3 visualizations, Python's, R, okay, other third party API integrations was become super easy in ClickSync. So since other BI tools are available in the market, like you see SAP BI, Oracle, IBM, Microsoft analysis services, but why ClickSync? Why the company ClickTech, who's introduced ClickSync, we have chosen here? Let's see. Why ClickSync? The unique selling point of ClickSync is it has in-memory analysis. It's a quick answer. When I say in-memory analysis, what it is? It is an analysis which has been done through a buffer model basically. So ClickSync, although it has a web-based interface, ClickSync is a web-based interface. So although it has a web-based interface, but ClickSync is capable to store n number of data or a high volume of data in the front end, just because of this in-memory analysis. Now the benefit of in-memory analysis is to hold the data in the front end. As a result, every time when we hit on any analysis, it does not go to the back end. It does not go to the back end and does not do the round trips. So as a result, the data fetching is become super easy. But if you compare this with other BI tool like SSRS, every time you click on any visualization in the dashboard, the page will keep on refreshing, refreshing, refreshing. So it needs a this feature is very good for making front-end analysis without buffering. Now the next is dashboard and detailed analysis. In ClickSense, you can create visual dashboards. So dashboard is basically a frame where I can have multiple KPIs, multiple statistics, multiple user interfaces, multiple GUI objects, and all these objects, all the KPI, all the reports would be interrelated to each other. That's what the dashboard is. And when I say detailed analysis in the dashboard or in the reports, you can have a further drill downs. You can have a further groups. Okay, you can have a further nested analysis. That's what we call as a detailed analysis. When you hit on any particular year, you would be redirected to the next level and it will show you list of the months. When you hit on any specific say city or country, then it will take you to the next level, to state. Then same way it will also take you to the next level, to city, and next level to address, and so on. That's what the detailed analysis is. Make presentations. Just like you are creating a PPT presentation, you can also create a presentation in ClickSense. That feature is called as storytelling or storyboarding. In storytelling, you can consolidate various objects of multiple dashboards and create a composite presentation in a storytelling, which can be previewed as a PPT preview. When you do a PowerPoint presentation, you can simply navigate the pages by the light pane, right? The same way, you can create some PPT-like presentation. Maybe your dashboard could be have 20 pages. Say you are extracting few cream objects, a few summarized objects, and creating a PPT with say 5 pages. So you can navigate those 5 pages of PPT by light pane, by pointer. So it's just like a PPT presentation. You should have a small sort of screen toggling back and forward, and you can have some sort of animations. It will exactly look like a PPT. So this feature is quite new in ClickSense. If you compare this with other BI tool, you will nowhere find this. Link description and multimedia to data. So in ClickSense, you can link to various pictures, videos, or additional multimedia component to a dashboard. Build your own BI. What does it mean? This is mean for a user who is an end user, but himself, he can develop a new dashboard pertaining or having some small set of data. If you have provided us some sort of data in Excel or any other data source, any layman user also can create with any layman user with least amount of coding experience can create a BI tool for his own. So that's the easiness of ClickSense. So let us have a comparison of the legacy product ClickView with the hybrid product ClickSense. The legacy product ClickView has a feature rich options. Like, it was very much feature rich. What does it mean? ClickView has a lot of properties to deal with any objects. Ultimately, you must have the knowledge to understand those properties. And since you have a lot of property, it was feature-rich, but it was not user-friendly. If you compare this with ClickSense. So in order to create any chart, you must have to deal with a lot of property in ClickSense. But here in ClickSense, it is very much user-friendly because you can create ad hoc reports or easy ad hoc analysis in ClickSense. With 2 to 3 clicks, you can simply generate a chart. Whereas in ClickView, we are supposed to navigate to around 10 to 15 clicks with various properties. ClickView is highly interactive. ClickView had large knowledge base like Click Community. ClickView is highly customizable since it has a Windows-based solution or IDE. It has lot of property and it was highly customizable. Whereas if you see ClickSense, the new features are added, that is collaboratively multiple users can work on a single dashboard, which is not possible in ClickView. Storytelling is a new feature, or making presentation, that's newly added, which is not there in ClickView. Mobile platform for developing a responsive mobile dashboards was introduced in ClickSense, whereas it was not there in ClickView. Fast and cheap development in ClickSense. When I say first and click chief development means with employee with the least amount of coding knowledge as a fresher can also develop. That means the resource cost has been saved, chief development, and it is also faster. Why? Because it has a very less property to deal with any object, and hence you can quickly create dashboards without dealing with all the properties. Whereas for ClickView, resource should be a little bit experienced enough. You should have a little bit of some or good amount of coding knowledge to create a dashboard. Now, these are the distinct feature of ClickView in the left side and ClickSense in the right side. Now let's see, since both are belongs to one parent, that is Click. Click is also father of ClickView and Click is also father of ClickSense. Since both are belongs to same OEM, let's see what are the commonalities between ClickView and ClickSense. What are the common features being derived? That is QVD, ClickView data. So ClickView data is a flat file data source of Click. We can say ClickView data. This is common in both the ClickSense and ClickView. Both the platforms can read data from QVD. So that is common for both. Scripting for ClickView. Whatever the scripts we are using, like set analysis, if-else condition, conditional dimensions, conditional facts, all those scriptings are common in both the platforms. Despite of having very few features which is different in ClickSense, but most of the features of scripting is common. So if you know ClickView, it would be very easy for you to understand ClickSense, because the most of the features has been covered in ClickView. When you come to ClickSense, those topics can be omitted for you and you can learn the new topics in ClickSense. But for a new resource who is into BI, he must understand A to Z all the topics of ClickSense and ClickView. And then community, the ClickView community is also common for both the ClickSense and ClickView. And QIX, Click Information Exchange, there is a concept of ClickView that's also common in both the platforms. So I hope you would have liked this session. Thanks for watching. Keep following. Bye bye.